What's going on, good people? It's your boy, Eric Taylor, Taylor 2 Coaching. And thank you for coming for the first time or returning to my YouTube channel. It's time to continue my Pluto series. And like always, I gotta take you to the future. Pluto and Aries, all right? Cardinal fire sign. I hope you saw my Pluto and Pisces video. I'm going there with Pluto and Aries. We're talking 2067 until 2097. Really doesn't enter into Taurus till 2098, end of January. So, what's Pluto? We're talking about Hades, the underworld, right? We're talking about transmutation, transformation, the soul psyche, power, control, obsession, manipulation, sex, lies, debt, taxes, inheritance, other people's money, right? Pluto is this magnetic energy. Now, that's a lot of that stuff is, you know, eighth house stuff, but Pluto, it is that manifesting energy to pull in money from other people through marriage, right? It's the deep investigation. Pluto takes us underground to the hidden subjects, to the ancient herbs, to the oils, the gems, the crystals, to white magic, black magic, Brujeria, Santeria, Yoruba, astrology, tarot, metaphysics. Stuff that they told you was no bueno. Aries the ram, forget the flim flam, let me tell you who I am. The baby, the child, the first house. This is sort of like Pluto in the first house, but it's very different because it depends on what your ascendant is. I'll do Pluto through the house of Ceres. This is just Pluto and Aries. Ruled by Mars. Pluto and Mars, they both meet up together in Scorpio, right? Similar, but very different energies. But Mars is the warrior, the soldier, the fighter. These people, oh my God, it's power. It's magnetic, it's transformative. It's yes. They're not down to hear no. They don't want to hear your no's, receive your no's. But at this time, what is Aries? The first sign, right? The sun is exalted in Aries. Because it's like the flame, the fire, the spark. When we get to Pluto and Aries, we might be starting everything all over again. After the big drowning, or through the big war, World War III, World War IV, who knows? You don't know. Let's walk and talk about it, Hulk about it, New York about it. I mean, you gotta love Uranus and Taurus bringing us this new Earth. Because Pluto and Aries, it's going to start a fire. There's going to be more than just New Earth. We're talking about think about it for a second. Maverick, pioneering energy. Strong, independent women. Brilliant, pushing the envelope men. reconstructing and advancing this new world, new species. I'll be close to leaving then. My grandchildren, maybe great-grandchildren, will be enjoying it. 2067 to 2097. What's burning? Who's leading? What will the babies even be like? Now, one could say that we'll already be on Mars and living, and we'll have hybrid Mars and Earthling babies here. Some might be afraid to talk about that or say that. Aries itself is about getting it done and initiating and sparking, right? It sparks. It heats it up. It's that drive, that power, that initiation, that energy. It's competitive. It's survival. So Pluto is saying, how are you going to literally exist in this, dance in this, bring birth and reality to this? Because that's what's real. Being the baby, starting over. Being at the beginning. When I think about Aries and then I think about the intensity of Pluto, is it Mortal Kombat? Is this like the end game? Or the new game? And would 2066 be sort of that cusp of rebirth where we literally are going through that final frontier where we've got to find the new fire and the new flame on Mount Olympus, the new torch, and be like, here it is again. I mean, what do you want it to be? Maybe that's the better question. How are you vibrating? How do you think it should be? How should we exist? How will you exist? I mean, you know, when I think about Pluto in itself, I mean, this is very raw. It's raw obsession, raw sex, raw control. Earth and humanity and the concepts, all this, it can be and will be a new beginning. Will we have to repopulate? Or will there just be a new species here, a new humanity? Or no more humans? Because it can be brilliant, maverick, pioneering energy, it also means that when that spark comes, you gotta be willing to boogie and move and dance and realize that, you know, Mars energy is about winning. Pluto is about manifesting and power and control. So who's winning? Who's got control? Who's gonna dominate? Who's going to build, destroy, and rebuild? Are you ready for that? Do you even want to deal with that? Or better yet, what does that even look like? Because Aries wants to kind of just touch and experience everything. And Pluto's like, how are we growing? How are we taking this pain, trauma, and crises and then manifesting it to be this general warrior, pioneering, maverick soldier? Is it after you've gone through the battle and the war? Is it after you chewed off somebody's face? I mean, sounds kind of violent and crazy, but what do we got to dance with here? What do we have to experience? Aries doesn't want to be still and sit still. And there's a nervous energy. And that's why I keep moving around, because I want to wake you up and let you understand Pluto and Aries 2067 is not a game. It's not a joke. You don't know. I don't know. But I do know this. We're talking about serious transformation and change. That is beyond intense, right? I mean, you know, it's real. Are you real? Are you ready? So there will be leaps of leaving back or behind childlike behaviors and becoming this warrior general that becomes the pioneer maverick that says, I will lead us with this new fire, with this new light, with this new species, this new brain, so that we can transcend and be in the ninth dimension. That we are now no longer seven chakra, we're now a nine chakra system. That I can read minds telepathically, teleport, use, or rebuild broken technologies. God, it is so hot and bright. Do you know what I mean? Do you? That's what Pluto's talking about in Aries. This is real pain, trauma, crises. This is real war. This is real maverick pioneering energy. This is real competition, blood games, end game. Or it could just finally be like, oh, it's the Jetsons and we're flying and cars are, you know, this and that. And you know what I mean? Like, it could be just that simple too. I'm ready for all of it. I invite all of it. But be prepared either way, because that spark is you. Whether it's the children of you, the grandchildren or the great-grandchildren of you, the spark is you. Will you flame that spark so that it can blossom, grow, lead, pioneer, fight, exist, breathe, 2067, 2077, 2087, 2097? Huh? Freaking bugs. I'm waiting for my bug zapper to come in the mail. But Pluto and Aries, like, these people, their soul is going to have them literally be at the dawn of the new century, 2100, where I hope someone sees this as we go to Pluto and Taurus. And you understand that being a part of the new beginning, the brave new world, you have to be ready for everything. For the Jetsons, for guerrilla warfare, for complete isolation and rubbing two sticks together or two rocks together and starting a fire. From learning how to create fires with your hands, with your thought, through deep meditation. Whatever it needs to be. It's so hot out here, it feels like a fire. But I've got to do that for you. So, I hope you look forward to the future, whether you're here for it, your children, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren, and you leave them with this insight that they need to understand that no matter whether it's skyscrapers or solar or wind energy or whatever it is, that they have got to be ready to embrace anything. Lead anything, handle and deal with anything. These women they're already born warriors. Pluto and Aries is it's beyond sexual. It's primal carnal sex. It's like the pheromones walking past each other and it's like, yeah, I want to do you. Let's do it. Yeah, think I'm playing. And there's not really the want to control, because Aries is so independent. It's not about controlling, it's about leading, or I'm out. Oh, you don't want to rock with me like this? Okay, see ya. Because they're still going to do it and get it done by themselves. God, these plants, the allergies, man, bugs. So, as I end the dissertation, Pluto and Aries, I say and bid you adieu with this. Taylor 2 Coaching. Hit me up at taylor2coaching@gmail.com. I know some of these futuristic videos are too far out for you guys, but trust me when I tell you, I'm not far off, and somebody needs to receive this and see this and understand how to breathe the best you can underwater and through the mud. Understand the knowledge of what the Egyptians did in terms of how they built the pyramids. Understand pi. Understand geometry. Understand sculpting a world and city with your hands through whatever you have, sand, soil, clay. No fear. Pluto in Aries is not here to fear. It's to soar, compete, fight, survive, initiate, birth, touch, inspire. All right, Pluto in Aries? Mutate on that. Run, tell that. You tell them T2UC, Big 3 Astrology told you. Okay? Like always, y'all comment down below. Run your race. Run your race, Pluto and Aries. I know you'll get it done. And I thank you already. In 2067, you watch this, hit your boy up. My kids and my grandkids will tell you what's going on with me. All right? Eric Taylor, Taylor 2 Coaching. I got you. Hit me up before my my prices go up July 1st, 2021. All right? Thursday. So, enjoy Cancer season, June. It's cardinal energy. Powerful 2-3 weeks coming up. Be mindful, be careful in 2021. T-square, Uranus, Taurus, Saturn, Aquarius, Mars, Leo. It's not that game. Venus and Leo, get your love on, get your shine on, get your bright on. All right, but Pluto and Aries. Thank you. Thank you for the new beginning. Thank you for continuing the existence of Earth. And if you're half Mars, half human, Martian human, or moon hybrid human, or whatever, or just an alien watching, or an Archon Reptilian watching, I know. Do you know me? Pluto and Aries. Taylor 2 Coaching. Magnetic, fiery. New beginning. Sign up for that. Peace. Taylor 2 Coaching.